this episode of Death Battle is brought to you by Angry Video Game Nerd 2 Assimilation. Buy it! Right now!
It's the most unlikely...
Here we go! It's Ratchet and Clank versus Jak and Daxter. A very long-awaited one.
Sometimes the most unlikely of friends can become the best of heroes.
Ratchet and Clank, the Cosmic Commandos.
And Jak and Daxter, the Masters.
I'm currently
of
on the fence on
He's
this one.
He wears an arm boomstick.
And it's our job to analyze their weapons, armor, and skills to find
this
out who
ought to
would
be interesting.
Win a death battle.
Oh, jeez. Was that from PS Move?
It was a time of chaos. The unstoppable Kragmite Empire wreaked havoc across the galaxy until a race of unlikely heroes fought back. The Lombaxes. Who may be some sort of lemur wombat?
Well, whatever they are, they're pretty good at kicking the shit out of Kragmites and ended up stopping the Empire by banishing them to another dimension. Well, all except one, and boy would that come back to bite them in the ass.
Raised as one of their own, the last Kragmite betrayed his foster Lombaxes, raised an army of fish people, and in some sense of cruel ironic justice, banished the entire Lombax race to their own dimension as well.
Jeez.
And just as ironically missed one who would prove to be his greatest adversary.
This lone Lombax's name was Ratchet, and he spent most of his days stranded on a random planet digging around with
Dead
mechanical
meat
stuff and
by Captain Quark
one day exploring the galaxy.
Oh, Quark is one to talk.
Kitty cat thing scrounged up all the scraps he could
find, you're one to
used
talk,
his
Quark
natural gift with machines, and built a spaceship so incredible it would finally take him off this boring planet once and for...
Without an onboard robot ignition system, this hunk of junk would never fly.
And with Ratchet's luck, it's not like one was just gonna drop out of the sky or anything. Well, I'll be damned!
This was the Sentry Bot serial number XJ0461.
Well, that's hard to say in conversation, and he makes a clanky sound when he falls over, so...
Maybe I'll just call you Clank.
Clank had just been assembled maybe half an hour earlier and was already running for his life.
Yeah, see, he came from a robot killing machine making
an interdimensional being and a conveyor belt.
And made this little guy. He decided to scrap him for parts. So naturally, he got the hell out of there, ended up with Ratchet, and together they became the greatest hero duo in the galaxy.
While they started out as an unlikely pair, they've picked up all sorts of experience along the way. Ratchet has been trained as a commando and is proficient in martial arts, heavy weaponry, survival skills, stealth,
ballroom dancing, and origami.
That's pretty
and
impressive.
Despite his
powerful
diminutive
skills.
Size, Clank is an asset in combat as well. When paired with Ratchet, he can act as a personal helicopter or even a jetpack.
Also, turns out Clank wasn't a mistake after all.
He possesses the soul of a Zoni, energy-based creatures with the ability to manipulate time and be immune to time-altering effects. And eventually, these powers
manifest. I can definitely see Ratchet
well
and Clank winning.
That's
now.
Right. He's a robo-time wizard.
Who did you say gave you this thing?
The Sony. They are little invisible creatures who travel through time.
Oh, right.
Both Ratchet and Clank are loaded with nanotech, microscopic machines which instantly repair their bodies after any injury, though their number is limited.
But Ratchet and Clank's true strength lies up their arsenal. Ratchet's packing your usual Solana-style weaponry, from his trusty Omni-Wrench to rocket launchers. But the real beauty lies in all his wacky weapons, like the Vortex Cannon, which sucks up tiny enemies and blasts them back out like little flaming meteors. The Mini Turret Glove can deploy dozens of auto-targeting machine guns, which can destroy tanks. And of course, there's also a Disco Ball, which forces foes to helplessly dance before them.
Yeah, the Groovatron!
Ratchet's gadgetry also includes energy shields, close-range shredder claws, and a variety of drones to assist him in battle. He's even picked up a gun that
Mr.
turns
Zircon
enemies
is
into
ready
tiny,
to
adorable
kill
sheep.
But hang on, we can't forget my all-time favorite, the Rhino 5.
Oh.
Part minigun, part rocket launcher, this beauty unleashes a glorious river of death in whatever direction she's facing. All set to Tchaikovsky's 1812 Overture.
I'm honestly surprised you know how to say his name.
Oh yeah, the dude played my favorite musical instrument.
What, the piano?
Cannon.
No.
Cannons.
Cannons.
Oh.
Anyway, in their adventures, Ratchet
Tarkovsky,
and Clank
yes.
have pretty impressive.
Tarkovsky, always yes!
To win numerous gladiator battles, strong enough to stop the blow of a ward rock with nothing but an Omni Wrench, fast enough to dodge close range laser fire, tough enough to survive an explosive shipwreck, and even the vacuum of space.
However, their ability to survive deadly blows is entirely dependent on their supply of nanotech. If they run out of microbots, the next blow is sure to be fatal. But Ratchet and Clank's greatest strength doesn't come from any outlandish weapon or body-rebuilding nanomachine. Rather, it is their unbreakable bond of friendship and teamwork.
Oh, God, that was so friggin' lame.
Robots are not so easily fooled.
Ah, what's that?
What?
Long
okay, let's see what Jak
and
Daxter have.
Life,
if there's
a,
and if there's anything
Eco.
I missed on them.
Left behind
so
by
there,
godlike beings called the Precursors, Eco came in six different types, each possessing a different power. But what became of the Precursors? How did they harness the power of Eco? The answers, they say, lie in the destiny of the mischievous teenage boy named Jak.
Jak was born into royalty as the son of King Dumbass.
His name is Mar.
Dumbass, ruler of Haven Fitting. City. But Jak lost his future as heir to the throne when some douche named Baron Praxis
spoke his first
birthday.
Age 17.
The former
yeah.
king was separated from his son and banished to the wastelands, leaving Jak to grow up a wandering orphan.
Until he was taken in and raised by Samos, the elder of Sandover Village. Here, he met his best friend to be, Daxter.
Oh, I don't know why he would ever want to be friends with a guy that never shuts up.
The sage yaps on about the precursors that built this place all the time. Where did they go? Why did they build this place?
Surprisingly good hacker.
Before long, Jak and Daxter became inseparable and did just about all their teenage tomfoolery
together. Clank.
Like stealing a speedboat to explore the Forbidden Misty
yep.
Island.
Yeah, turns out it was
the Kickstarter of the first game's plot.
Reason.
Yep. There we go.
Man, that stung.
Oh no, he fell into the weasel pool.
Well, technically, he fell into a pool of dark ego, which transformed him into an otzel. Whatever the hell that's supposed to be.
Daxter took it pretty well, all things considered.
I'm fine.
Nope.
By the way, where's the unweasel pool?
It's not so simple. In order to reverse Daxter's transformation, they would have to find the Sage of Dark Eco.
Yeah,
to prepare them for this journey, Samos trained them to harness the power of Eco and, in turn, to become formidable warriors.
With green Eco, Jak can restore lost health and create shields. With yellow Eco, he can launch energy projectiles from his hands. Blue Eco doubles his speed and reflexes, and red Eco does the same for his strength, allowing him to take down tough enemies with a single strike.
But when their tinkering with ancient precursor technology sent them tumbling into a dystopian future, it's a long story. Jak was captured and experimented on by Baron Praxis, who wanted to turn him into a super soldier.
Too bad he didn't really know what he was doing, and poor Jak was stuck as his lab rat for two straight years, until Daxter finally busted him out. Jak was so happy, he spoke his first words ever.
I'm gonna kill Praxis!
Yep!
Aww, my first words were beer! Now!
Unbeknownst to Praxis, while his experiments failed to turn Jak into Captain America, they did grant him the ability to consume Dark Eco and temporarily transform into the mighty Dark Jak.
Dark Jak can use Dark Eco for a bunch of powerful projectiles, and he can even triple in size and strength. On top of that,
jeez.
Dark Jak is also completely invulnerable.
That's right, we bad. You haven't forgotten what I taught you, Jak.
If one super form wasn't enough, Jak gained another when he came face to face with the precursors themselves. And turns out they're all otzels like Daxter.
Oh my god.
They gave him the ability to consume light eco in order to counterbalance the darkness within.
Never guess what they called it. Give up, it's light, Jak.
In this form, Jak can glide through the air, create a force field, regenerate from wounds, and even freeze time itself.
Looks like Jak.
And there's not enough dark light eco on
hand. So Jak has time powers too.
People with godlike energy, Jak wields one of the most versatile weapons ever created, the Morph Gun. Powered by different types of eco, it can work like a shotgun, grenade launcher, or minigun. It can fire ricocheting laser shots, homing needles, and even freaking lightning!
And when Jak sets the Morph Gun to Mass Inverter mode, it can blast a wave of dark eco so absurd it alters the very laws of gravity on
I think Jak and Daxter got this.
Yeah, but if that fails, they can just blast him with a supernova. It basically one-shots about anything.
This place has too much excitement. We need to move back to the country.
Armed to the teeth with weapons and eco, Jak and Daxter successfully dethroned Praxis and saved Haven City thanks to several impressive feats along the way.
Like getting up no problem after being crushed in a cave-in, or tearing through solid metal doors like wet paper. Daxter helps when he can, usually by steering missiles into people, but most of the heavy lifting is done by Jak.
Like the one time he did this.
Yep.
Jak and Daxter are incredibly resourceful. They won a gladiator-style battle with nothing but an unmodified morph gun.
And their drive to win is so strong they even took first in the Crash City Grand Championship while poisoned.
Even giant terraforming robots trying to destroy the world fall to their teamwork, provided they have enough eco.
They can only carry so much eco at once, roughly under a minute's worth in combat for each color type, and so they rely on replenishing their power by pulling eco from the environment. Also, Jak can be a bit reckless and doesn't always think things through.
Even still, don't underestimate the duo
okay,
of
it's
Jak
back
and
on
Daxter.
The fence, then.
It's the last thing a lot of bad guys ever did.
All right, the combatants are set. Let's end this debate once and for all.
But first, remember that game we told you about last time? You can buy it now. The Unlockable Arm 2 Assimilation is available right now on Steam,
skipping,
PC, Mac, and Linux. So what are you waiting for? Go pick it up. But right now, it's time for a death battle!
All right. Good one. Daxter, is that you? Oh, nope, that's Ratchet and Clank.
That's the last time I let Quark fix the warp system.
Actually, weren't you the one who overclocked the accelerator?
Huh. This is new.
Here's Jak.
Hey, do you have any idea what you've done?
Yeah, hey guys. Welcome to our home. Make yourself comfortable on the couch. If you can find what's left of it.
Nah, this isn't so bad.
Nope.
I can fix that.
I'm very sorry for your loss, Mr. Weasel.
Uh-oh.
Weasel. Well. Looks like it's us who needs to fix you.
All right.
One more for your mama. Get up, Jak.
They forgot to mention the hoverboard. Daxter. Poor Daxter.
Hey, Fuzzball! You're pissing me off! I got him! Mercy?
No. You're done for! Watch out!
You can't keep up!
Rest in pieces.
Whoa!
Ratchet!
Clank to the rescue!
you go any faster?
I wasn't designed for this.
Let's try this.
Any more weapons you want to throw at me?
Like I need any more.
Dark Jack time.
Huh. Well, maybe just one more.
Oh, he's riding
behind us.
Now what?
Here we go.
Get up, Jack.
Light, come on, Jack. Light, he comes. Now, is Clank gonna turn this around? Well, that was easy.
And curtain.
KO!
Not the weasel guy!
Jak and Daxter were formidable fighters, especially when they had enough eco on hand. But Ratchet and Clank's better teamwork, superior defenses, and overwhelming arsenal trumped them in the end.
Well, they both had ways to patch themselves up. Ratchet's nanotech was way more reliable and plentiful than Jak's green eco.
And Ratchet's shields and incapacitative weaponry were more than enough to put a stop to Jak's more offensive eco.
Haha, take that, nature!
While Jak and Daxter's morph gun was one of the most versatile weapons we've ever seen, it absolutely pales in comparison to the sheer size and power of Ratchet and Clank's arsenal.
Yeah.
Jak's best shot was his dark form, but like everything Jak and Daxter had, it didn't take long to run out of juice. Well, Ratchet and Clank had more than enough gadgets and weaponry to keep up the fight.
Plus, Clank is an infinitely more capable sidekick than Daxter.
Yeah, that's true.
His time manipulation and immunity powers.
It was game overture for Jak and Daxter.
The winners are Ratchet
game
and
overture.
Clank.
Oh, that's beautiful. Okay, who's
time
next?
Time on Death Battle.
Flash. Yep, it's the Flash. All right. Is he fighting Quicksilver? I bet he's gonna fight Quicksilver.
Hey everybody, I'm Chad. I play Boomstick.
I'm Ben. I play Wiz.
Quicksilver is
so
the only fitting
Ratchet
opponent I can think of for
Daxter.
Flash.
And remember, you can watch the next episode early by signing up for a sponsorship if you don't have one already. You can click the link below, and there's even a 30-day free trial.
Nice. And then you'll get to see Flash versus... You can find out by racing on over to our social media, at ScrewAttack on Twitter, official SA on Facebook.
But yes.
Thank you guys so much for watching the video. Like, subscribe, and check out these other cool videos like... What is it, Pokemon Be Crazy? And the mystery video, of course, which takes you to the internet? Or yeah.
But yeah. Well, I should have expected this. Ratchet and Clank had the more reliable gear, and Clank was the more reliable partner overall. So, yeah, I should have seen that coming. But congrats to both teams. They did good. So next time, we'll see the Flash versus someone, most likely Quicksilver. See you next time!